On April 4th, 1999, I arrived home from school. I just graduated. It took a few semesters longer than I originally planned, but I was proud to be done. I had no idea what adult life held for me, but I was optimistic.
Alex, dear son of mine, please see if you can muster up the energy to walk into town and pick up some groceries. I've included a list below.
Not even home 5 minutes and she's already barking orders at me.
change the nature of all realities, both yours and mine.
What?
The needle of the record player has dropped. Can't you hear the music? It's everywhere.
That phone call was surely one of the strangest I've ever received. And no, I couldn't hear the music. A few hundred yards outside of town, I came to a junction. Mulling over the strangeness of being back home, I stopped to notice a forest I'd never explored. It was dark, but somehow attractive. I made a mental note to explore it later, and took a step towards town when I heard a meow near my feet. I pictured what it would be like to be the owner, and I imagined describing him to a friend. Lonely? Nah. I don't get too lonely. Besides my mom, there's only a cat. An old cat. But a good friend to talk to. My fictional friend would reply, "You talk things over, do you?" I'd nod. Uh-huh. Been together a long time, so we can read each other's moods. I understand what makes the cat tick. The cat knows what makes me tick. Of course, I didn't know this cat at all. Never met. He was a funny-looking cat, with a funny resting face and a Salvador Dali mustache. I couldn't imagine picking out this cat to bring home from a store. I leaned down to pet him, without entirely knowing if cats like to be pet at all. His coarse hair ran through my fingers as he purred. Clearly he liked me. That was a good sign. Alex Eagleston, college graduate, friend of small animals.
Hey! Give them back to me!
Yeah.
Stepped into the elevator, expecting to find the cat. I scanned the dark floor and found nothing. I sighed as the elevator began to shake, vibrating with motion. The elevator came to a smooth but unexpected stop. I cringed with anxiety as the lights flickered. Please don't die, please don't die. I pleaded with the mechanical gods to keep the power on. My prayers weren't answered. Damn it! The power's out! I need to find the stairs, or a fuse box!
Hey!
Hey! Who's there? Don't come any closer. I'm armed.
Relax and quiet down. It's me, Panda.
Panda? Why are you here?
I came here to help you. I'm always there for you when you need me.
That's good to hear. What sort of help did you have in mind?
My primary use is as a barrier. I can block oncoming enemy attacks and create barriers between you and many other obstacles. My metal shield makes me very heavy, so you can use me to hold down switches and to clear small gaps by stepping on my head. You can press to summon me. Remember to press again to call me back. Also remember that some weighted switches will have reverse effects if you take me off.
So, press it to summon you and press it again to take you back? I think I get it.
I hope so, Alex. It's rather straightforward. However, since you were a liberal arts major, want me to explain this entire thing again?
Tears seem to power the room. What the hell is going on here?
Thank you. who's there. Dolly, is that you?
Great, another person.
Hey, I can leave if you'd like.
No, please stay.
I've been pretty lonely here.
Where is here, anyway?
I was hoping you'd know. I've been lost down here forever.
Did you come through the elevator, too?
Elevator? I don't know what that is.
Then, where did you come from? I asked, thinking it sounded nicer than, who the hell doesn't know what an elevator is?
I came from here. Is there anywhere else? Anyway, I've been looking for my cat, Dolly. Have you seen her?
So the stupid thing was a girl? I just assumed it was a boy cat, seeing as how it had a spindly mustache. Although, now that I reflected on it, facial hair was not exclusive to male animals or male humans, for that matter. Is that the cat who looks like Salvador Dali?
I don't know who that is. My cat just looks like Dolly herself, not another cat named Salvador.
She didn't know elevators. I doubted she'd know her 20th century Spanish Catalan surrealist painters all that well either. I said, right, I saw a cat earlier. He had a funny mustache and crazy eyes. Naturally, my description of her beloved feline was offensive to her. Clearly, this was a woman projecting a rather strong personality onto this cat. She took a deep breath and said quickly,
my cat has a beautiful mustache and perfect eyes. I can't imagine we're talking about the same cat.
I told her I wouldn't mind helping her find her cat. I told her we should move quickly and get out of this dank basement. I waited for a moment as she processed what I said. She was a very difficult girl to read, especially without being able to see her face. I could tell something was wrong. She really projected her opinions and feelings into the room, even without saying them. What's wrong? I don't have to help. I just thought you could use an extra pair of cat hunting eyes.
It's not that. It's okay. Forget it.
Hey now, that's lame. You can tell me anything, no judgment here.
No judgment? Great lie, I like a good liar.
Hey, I'm serious. I didn't mean anything by that.
It's not you. That wasn't fair of me. It's just, the world has used me so unkindly, I fear it's made me suspicious of everyone. Okay, for now, I choose to trust you, but I reserve the right to decide you're just as evil as the rest of the world in the future.
Sounds like a fair deal. My name is Alex. Nice to meet you.
I'm Sammy, but please call me Sammy. I don't know why I'm trusting you. I guess I always had a special spot for gingers.
Hey, careful with that word. That is our word.
What do you mean, our word? You're weird, Alex.
Sorry, lame joke. Let's just look for the cat. Thank you.
where have you been? I'm so happy to have you back. Oh, who's a good cat? You are. You are.
Oh, I should probably tell you about Dali. Dali is a tool, much like your stuffed panda friend. Use Dali to fetch items and hit switches that are too far away for you to reach. Dali can jump, so don't worry about her falling down any gaps. This will be useful, so make sure you try it. Okay, so shall we get out of here? Sorry about my house. I've been meaning to get someone in here to fix the power, but who has the time for that? I get so busy that little things like that get away from me. But that's normal, isn't it? You get used to the flaws in your own home. It's always confusing for guests. Like, my mother used to have everyone take their shoes off in the kitchen. Who does that? Oh no, I've become my mother. Oh, one last thing I should warn you about. I've got a roommate. His name is Wilhelm. Well, you'll see.
am so happy we're almost out of here. This isn't really what I expected to be doing with my day.
Well, at least we found Ellie. Imagine how much worse it would have been without her.
Right. So, where do you live? I'll walk you back home, or maybe I can borrow my mom's car and drive you if it's outside of Franklin.
What do you mean? This is my home. This is where I live.
What? You live in this shithole?
That's not very nice. I'd never call your house the rat hole because I have manners. Ever heard of them, Alex?
Sorry. It's just not every day I meet a girl who lives in an old factory.
I don't see it that way. I almost feel as if the factory lives with me. As if the factory, just like Dali, is part of me.
The factory is part of you?
Wow, you're almost as dumb as you look. Of course, the factory isn't part of me. That's just weird.
But do you actually live here?
Yeah. Just me and Dali. But usually Dali is better about keeping me company, you know? He's not always just running off to God knows where.
I reflected on her words. A mysterious girl who lived with her cat in an old steel mill. It was obvious to me that her words didn't contain the entire truth. Something about her compelled me. Pieces of her story started to fit together in my mind. Well, at least that's what I thought at the time. I can admit now that some pieces were pure fabrication on my part. In my head, her story went something like this. Sammy was homeless. A runaway woman who was trying to escape hard times. Someone who had found refuge in her cat. Maybe the only thing left from her previous life. Somehow this felt right inside my head. But still, I could tell I was missing something. Her clothes were clean. Her breath was fresh. She was much more energetic than the homeless girl I'd ever known. Not that I'd known many. The secret to what I was missing lay in her temperament.
Is that your hobby?
Is what my hobby?
Staring off into space and screwing up your face as if to say, what's going on inside my head is really important, so just let me think.
Hey, I don't make that fit.
For less than 2 hours when she vanished from my sight. Sammy was gone for good, swept away as if she'd never been there at all. A door into nothing, into a different reality, opened up and swallowed Sammy whole. At that moment, I couldn't think. I couldn't breathe. All I could do was replay the scene of her being pulled into obscurity by nothing. There one second and gone the next.
Thank you.
night wind of springtime seemed to contrast the inner workings of my brain. I was moving on autopilot back towards my home. I felt as if I'd seen something that wasn't meant to be seen. As if the curtain had lifted on reality and exposed the man upstairs. Like I just found out Santa wasn't real. I couldn't yet put into words what I now understood. Something had changed inside of me. Pulsating through my veins was the energetic charge of irrevocable loss all for a woman I didn't know. This feeling wasn't pure. It was cut with something I couldn't put my finger on at the time. I believe now that it was a profound sense that I had discovered something. Only problem was this something wasn't meant to be seen. In that moment, I was a child finding a magazine meant only for an adult's eyes. I was both intrigued and repulsed, confused by the images spinning inside my head. When I arrived home, tired, confused, and out of breath, I tossed my things on the floor and made my way to the couch. My mother still wasn't home yet. I wasn't surprised. She often worked late right before her company released a new product. My mother, a 49-year-old, short, red-headed woman, was an information systems programmer analyst for Pacific Chime, the West Coast's leading telecommunications provider. Her job, ironically located on the East Coast, worked her harder in 1 year than most jobs work people in a decade. This job paid well. Without it, my sister and I would have never gotten through college. I left school debt-free thanks to the back-breaking mental labor of my mother.
You have mail.
There was a moment of apathy where I almost didn't click the link. The last thing he sent me that was allegedly scary turned out to be a picture of two elephants locked in the throes of passion. I sighed and clicked the link. The file was 2.9 megabytes. In the dark room, the monitor was hurting my eyes. I rubbed them and waited for the file to load. Of all the things could be. More animal porn, human porn, cartoon porn. You could never really guess with this guy. But it was most certainly going to be pornographic.
Maybe a girl from my high school was now into adult videos and was doing some particularly unladylike things. While the video loaded, I thought of all the girls I had gone to school with who might be involved in such activities. All the girls that came to mind neither had the looks nor the motivation to seek out an adult filmmaker. I gave up. I'd just have to wait for it to finish downloading. When the file had finished downloading, I waited with fading patience for my computer to open it in quick time. Finally, it was loaded.
So, is this what a college graduate does? Spend hundreds of thousands of his mother's hard-earned money to lounge around all day? It's already 2 p.m. Don't you think you should be getting out of bed?
Just, can you keep it down, please? I had a rough night. Can't get that video out of my head.
Alex, ask you a serious question.
Do you have to? It's too early for serious questions.
That doesn't work with me. I'm not your mommy. I don't let you get away with letting things slide.
Okay, fine. What is it then?
Why didn't you go back and look for her after she vanished from the elevator? Why did you run straight home?
If you had seen her being pulled out of the elevator, you'd have known she was gone for good, too. Besides, it's...
You're forgetting that I was there. I saw it, too, and I get it. You're scared, right? So you ran home. I understand. But maybe when you've mustered up some courage, you can put on your big boy pants and see if you can find her.
Maybe.
Now get yourself out of bed. Take a shower. You smell terrible.
I knew he was right. I couldn't let myself live with the guilt of not going back to look for her. Why did I run away? Why did I just stand there and let her get pulled into what? What exactly had she been pulled into? Just the thought of going back to the factory made my stomach tighten. didn't go back, I knew I'd never be able to live with myself. I think there was a part of me that didn't believe what my eyes had seen. That I was missing something. Some vital piece of information that slipped my mind. The whole thing could be explained logically.
We are inside a room. We can tell from the decorations on the wall that it is a female's room. The unremarkable but adequate lighting reveals to us that there is someone in the room, although who is not yet clear to us or the others in the room. The expressionless decor and bedding show uninteresting taste. Although there are the staples of a bedroom, there is something inhuman about the layout and decorations. We get the impression that the room is a parody of a human woman's room. With a quick survey of the interior, our eyes come to rest on a figure unconsciously placed inside the bed. We know from her plastic finish that she is both unconscious from a lack of humanity inside of her vessel and unconscious from a lack of power going to her circuits. The low electric hum of the room detracts from the music playing at a low level from a record player in the corner of the room. As we observe the motionless figure, we gradually come to sense that she isn't well, that she is broken in some way. We feel compelled to refer to the figure in the bed as a woman. However, her exposed circuitry holds our words. We bring the camera closer to her face and ponder what she is. Her face is lined with the most profound solemnance. We confer with each other and come to an agreement.
Okay, so let's review. You met a girl in an old factory and she vanishes within an hour of you meeting her. Now, with a new sense of bravery, you're running off to the last location you saw her to try and track her down.
Exactly.
Sounds good to me. I like this Alex with a sense of purpose. Now, if only you could get out of bed before 2 p.m.
I've had this song stuck in my head. It just won't go away. Did you ever get that? I think they call it an earworm or whatever. But this isn't really the catchy kind of song. This is that sort of thing. It's pretty good, but some of the lyrics are a bit weird. How did they go again?
I think you have the wrong number.
Oh, sorry.
Alex? You grew a beard!
As the young man got closer, my bewilderment grew. His name was Michael. He was a good kid, a bit younger than me, and usually worth a laugh or two. My hand covered my eyes to block the sunlight to see him better. I thought back to the last time I had seen him. For some reason, I couldn't place any memories of him since before high school. But I knew I must have seen him since then.
College makes you into a man.
Makes you into something.
What have you been up to?
Just took the SATs. That's about it.
Sounds intense. How do you think you did?
I was on the edge of my seat the whole time. But then I realized how uncomfortable it was to sit at the edge of my seat, so I sat normally.
What?
Just a little joke. Anyway, you look good. Well, maybe a few pounds heavier. Guessing you didn't major in exercise science.
Har har, very funny. Liberal arts.
Great. What do you do with that? Have any fun plans for the summer?
Nothing really. Just got back yesterday. I already spent the day chasing a cat and exploring that old factory by the water tower.
Oh wow, that sounds awesome! Hey, have you ever heard of urban exploration? There's this great website called www.onism1999.com. I think you'd really get a kick out of it. These guys break into old buildings and take photos. Usually the places they explore have some sort of urban legend behind them or a ghost story. Most of the stuff is legit and pretty damn creepy.
Did you say Onism 1999? Someone sent me a video from there yesterday. What else do you know about that site?
It's like a conspiracy theory support group. People from all over the world post about political conspiracies, local myths, stuff like that. You don't look so good, dude. Everything okay?
It's something from that page. It's been screwing with my brain.
What exactly did you see on there that has you so freaked out?
I don't know if you saw it or not. It was the one with the girl in the elevator? The one who gets lifted off the ground?
That was supposed to be filmed locally. I couldn't bring myself to watch it, but all those sick bastards made the gif of her being thrown around like a rag doll. That poor girl. After that went up, everyone on the forum started acting strange, like a sort of darkness had come over the website. It was the first time something like that had been posted that people weren't immediately calling a fake. Something about the look of horror in her face. It was a sick part of people that want it to be real, you know?
Yeah. Michael, when I first got to town and I saw that,
there was part of me that wanted to tell Michael everything. To get it all out in the open. But I couldn't bring myself to say it. There was something that felt personal, almost intimate, about my meeting with Sammy. Like, in that moment of her disappearance, we were linked. But it was for my eyes only. Her memory was for my thoughts only. But I needed to talk to someone about the situation. So I proceeded with caution.
All over that factory yesterday, and I swear the elevator in there was the same one as in the video. I know that sounds weird, but I really think that video was filmed there.
Really? Okay, let's check it out then.
What? Really? You want to go?
Yeah, why not? Do you mind if we run to the camera shop in Frankton really quick? I was getting my camera repaired. If we go in, I'm gonna want to take pictures. Photos would be like gold on Onism.
Yeah, sure. Let's just go quick.
That building isn't going anywhere anyway. Besides, the whole thing is probably a hoax. I checked the paper this morning and there wasn't a mention of a missing Frankton girl.
Yeah, okay. Let's just not let anyone beat us to the punch.
Thank you.
Way! They opened up an arcade in Frankton? That's awesome! Wow! How long has this been here? They opened it about 3 weeks ago. I still haven't gone in. I've been waiting until they fixed my camera so I could get some great photos of the place. I hear they have a bunch of import games.
Import games? From where?
Japan, mostly.
Aren't, like, all games made in Japan?
Well, at least the good ones are. Although there are some good RTSs on PC I've been playing lately, and I'm pretty sure those are made in the US.
Yeah? I never got into those kind of games myself. Always been more of an RPG guy.
RPG games are seriously the best! Chrono Trigger, Lufia 2, Secret of Mana! Those games are like the holy grail of my youth! I seriously don't think I'd be the person I am today if it wasn't for them.
Ever play Two Brothers? That's a sort of ARPG, although its focus really isn't on combat.
Two Brothers? Nope. That's a terrible name for a game, though. Sounds like a diner or a pizza place. Those guys really should work on their naming conventions.
Anyway, let's hit up the arcade really quick after we get your camera, and then head over to the factory. I just want to step in to smell that combination of grease and VO.
Yeah, let's do that then. Really? Grease and VO, dude? Yes! This place is the bomb! Wow! This is a lot better than I expected! There are so many beat arcades around.
Does that girl live in Frankton? I don't think I've ever seen her before.
I don't know. She's ancient anyway. What do you think she is, 26?
Hey now, that's really not that much older than me, dude.
Whatever, you're ancient too.
Let's come back here later, we should get to the factory.
Thank you.
something we never could have imagined. A being made of stars. The entire galaxy, no, the universe maybe, compressed into the silhouette of one entity. It hadn't noticed us at first. We were as insignificant to him as the trillions of stars at its core. But when provoked, it came after us, like we were the most sought-after thing in the universe. I'd been scared before. Everyone has, but those past memories of fright were nothing compared to what we had just experienced. As if a black hole incarnate had come to exist and it wanted us gone. As if consuming us was its only purpose. I couldn't say why I felt that way at the time, but I'd known it was true. And with all this in mind, Sammy's vanishing was starting to feel like the least supernatural thing I would experience.
witnesses.
That is how it feels to have your soul separate from your body. Do you wish to return to your physical form?
What the hell was that? What the hell is going on? Well, what just happened? What? Just, can you even believe what just happened? Oh man, dude, we need to get your photos developed. Developed? This thing is digital, baby! So what now? Do we just leave? I'm gonna go with... Yes!